Hey guys, Ralph here. Welcome to True Power Trumpet Fitness on this magnificent Monday here in Connecticut. Life's good, campers. Life's good. We got an early start. I got a crazy day today. Haven't played a note. Let me warm up a little bit. Ready to go. Let's see. Anyway, you saw the thumbnail. Vintage Lou Soloff. All right? I referred to him in a couple of the videos recently about mouthpieces and stuff. And my man Dion, just a plethora of great vintage type of YouTube vids and everything. Very, very interesting. It's a great chop shots of the great Lou Soloff. All right, let me honk, see what we got. Hey, I'm all warmed up. Yikes. Now, even Mel would blush at those first notes of the day. E's above double C. Guys, I had a great day practicing yesterday. My G's above double C were big as a house. I probably should have led with them today. But anyway, just killing it. Just killing it. Anyway, switching instruments, same mouthpiece. The reason I did that, Lou Soloff could have so benefited from the 1SB. So benefited from the 1SB. Guys, I told you I've worked with him a few times, not a lot. And I was sort of on the fringes of that whole group. I got their sloppy seconds. You know, somebody needed me immediately to get down to a session. Somebody needed a Broadway sub, something like that. I was just sort of taking everybody's crumbs. That was the, I had a nice little gig down in North Carolina with the principal trumpet in the North Carolina Opera. And subbed at the Met, made some bank with trumpet and everything. But I never really had my own show. I never really had my own account with a recording company or all that. I was on the fringes, taking everybody's crumbs, and did quite well. A lot of crumbs to be had if you're with the right people. But the whole point is, I did work a few times with Lou Soloff. And let's start here. Like me, like all of you, chops did not come easily to Lou Soloff. They absolutely did not. He worked tirelessly on them. He took several lessons with Jerry, and I didn't hear a lot of those lessons. You know, I'm coming in while he's coming out. He stopped and listened to more of my stuff than was very complimentary of it. But no, I did work with him a couple times, and I told you, he just came in with literally, guys, literally dozens of mouthpieces. Would look at the music on the stand and put three or four. And he would literally switch throughout a minute and a half, a minute jingle. He'd switch three, four times. Guys, that's guys that's struggling. He just was. Now, as you're going to hear in a minute, the results, he got the results. And he got the results for a long time, but he really, really worked hard at it. Worked very, very hard at it. Jerry and I did not know at the time what we know now. So, could we have helped him? I'm telling you what, the 1SB, he would have loved the 1SB. For the type of work that he did, you know, Roger Ingham said the other day he needs six. No, he could have stuck with one. As you're going to hear on the clip, his upper register on this little strained. It happens. I don't know what sort of playing he had done before he took the solo and all that sort of stuff. So, you know, no, who knows what he played during the day. But guys, he worked hard at it. He worked at it. Along the lines of Doc, I don't think he practiced as much as Doc. But again, the mouthpiece was crazy, and it did not come easy to him. And did he have a wonderful career? You bet. You bet. Musicianship off the charts, his jazz ability off the charts. With that said, okay, this clip you're going to look at, what beautiful, beautiful chop shots while he's playing. So many of the chop shots we see are publicity shots where they're just posing and they're not necessarily playing. This is right there, and you're going to see it from his left side. And guys, you will see. Locked in. No strain, no corner tension whatsoever. Locked in. Top lip, very, very thick. Bottom lip, thick and holding it up. If I could, again, just looking at this, if I could pinpoint what his struggles are. Now, Jerry and I did not have the tongue thing going back when he was studying with Jerry. Okay. Is his tongue in the right place? It's close. I don't think it is. Notes don't pop like, you know, Harry's and Doc's and all that sort of stuff. There's not that pop there. You'll hear it. But the tone is centered. The tone is pure. As I said, the lips themselves are locked in, and he may be overblowing a little bit. Again, faulty equipment, godforsaken mouthpieces that he brought in. That's another thing. It wasn't stock stuff. It wasn't Schilke mouthpieces. It was just that he used to put on the stand. It was just garbage. I don't know where he got it. Now, guy in his position probably had a lot of people making stuff for him. Make a call to one of the guys. Hey, can you give me a 7C with a little less this, you know. So it was not stock stuff. He would love the 1SB. We cut him back on the air a little bit. What I saw of the chops, he'd be absolute freaking powerhouse because the chop, the basic chop technique is there. And all this machinations, for another word, for lack of a better term, with the mouthpieces. High, low, soft, loud, small trumpet, B-flat trumpet, C trumpet, pick, cornet, all the same mouthpiece. He would have loved that. Like we all do. Anyway, and I'm going to get in my on my soapbox a little bit, guys. He died at 71. He was never a healthy man. That whole crew, again, that I was on the fringes for, and I'm not using him particularly, they dissipated terribly. They didn't sleep. They were up for days at a time doing God only knows what. They had fun, I guess. But 71, guys, I'm older than that, and my chops get better every day. You have to take care of the instrument. He did not. He did not. My advice to all of you: eat your fruits and vegetables, eat and drink your fruits and vegetables, get a kettlebell, and get the greatest, get a 1SB mouthpiece. Let me help you, the greatest chops of your life. Guys, we can all have better chops than Lusolov. Not the gifts. Those gifts came from God. The jazz ability and the musicianship and all that sort of stuff, that's a different thing. The chops we can all have. All right? All right. Eat and drink fruits and vegetables and live your life with true power. Not the fake stuff, true power. Love you all.